Good morning to you and you. Good morning. Good morning. Hi. It's good to be here. God is so good. He is so precious. He is so wonderful. And you know, he simply loves to give you surprises. So I hope that you woke up this morning and listened intently to the messages and the songs and the giving of praise that went before me. I trust that you lifted up your hearts and you lifted up your voices and worshipped the Lord with the last program. All right? God has blessed us this morning early, and we are here again to give you praise and to thank him for his wondrous, wonderful ways. We just love the Lord and we thank him. But before we continue, we will go forward and ask the Lord to get closer to us as we pray. Here he is.
God, for a closer walk with him. No matter how you try to get close to God, the enemy tries to intervene. But this is a prayer that you can pray if you want a closer walk with God.
Lord, I come to thee today. Please, Lord, take me as I am. Without you, I just can't make it. Thank you, Jesus.
Jehovah Raha, you are my shepherd, and I know with you I will not want. Lord, you said no good thing will you withhold from me. Lord, you said in Psalms 37 and 15, if I delight myself in you and commit and trust you, you will give me the desire of my heart and bring it to pass. Lord, my desire right now is not a house, not a car, not clothes, not earthly treasure. Father God, my greatest desire is to get closer to you in mind, body, spirit, will, and in emotion. Lord, I want to be saved. I want to be saved for real. I want to be a Christian at heart. Lord, I know Christianity is not a religion, but a relationship with you. Master, I crave that relationship. Lord, I need your power, your spirit, your anointing to dwell within me. Right now, Father, nothing else around me matters. I just want to work for you. Get more of your word within me. Go on the mission field for you and win souls. Father, whatever is hindering me, get close to me. Oh God, Father, I pray right now, Lord God, whatever is trying to hinder me from getting close to you, please reveal it, Lord God, or them, so I can renounce it. Father, if resentment, anger, unforgiveness, malice, favoritism, selfishness, haughtiness, moodiness, pride, or self-praise is found in me, please send your garbage truck right now to remove them. As I renounce them, I cast them out in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for a closer walk. Lord, destroy every whispering demon that's whispering negative things in my ears. When I want to get close to you, Lord, close my ear gate, my eye gate, my mind gate, my thought gate, that I will not yield, oh God, to the junk that these foul spirit is trying to feed me with. Lord, you know my struggles. You know my weaknesses, my challenges, and every dark area in my life. Lord, I ask according to John 14:14, to shine your light in me and remove every dark spot in my heart, that your light will shine through me wherever I go and to whomever I speak. Lord, all that I face and all that's been an obstacle in my way, I now rebuke, reject, renounce, denounce, and cast them out of my life and into outer darkness and into dry places to be chained until the day of judgment. Lord, I command them never to return to me, nor anyone or anything that I am associated with. Lord God, I thank you. Lord, I speak freedom into my life. Lord, I speak freedom from these multiple personalities that's been holding me hostage against my will. Lord, send your yoke-breaking anointing to break this struggle of bondage in Jesus' name. Oh God, and I cast them out into the abyss. Thank you, Lord, I am free. No longer bound, no more chains holding me. Praise God, I am free. I am free to get close to you In Jesus' name, thank you for freedom. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Indeed, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, we are free. Free to praise our God. Free to come and worship Him with you. And I trust that you're up and ready and willing and going forward with me. This is 92.9 FM Choice Radio. This is Choice Radio. And you know that it's the choice you make for your life, your salvation, and your choice. And you're listening to Victory in Praise with Miss S. And so we're going to praise our God and big Him up and give Him the glory. Here it is.
The sacrifice of praise shatters my darkness. Celebrating God's love makes way for His joy to fill up my emptiness, heal all my pain. It's a fruit of my lips to give thanks to His name. I will lift up my hands, I will bow on my face, I will dance with my feet, I will jump up and praise. I will shout it out loud, He's released me from shame. All the nations shall worship, and I'll do the same. Praise You, God.
Praise You, God. Praise You, God.
Praise You, God.
Praise You,
great, 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 great God. Praise You, God. The forgiveness He gives scatters all demons. Recognizing His voice destroys all my fears. He pours out His mercies and clothes me with peace. I will live to rejoice in His goodness to me. I will lift up my hands, I will bow on my face, I will dance with my feet, I will jump up and praise. I will shout it out loud, He's released me from shame. All the nations shall worship, I'll do the same. Praise You, God.
Praise You, God.
Praise You, great, 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 great God. Praise You, God. Why should I hold back and cling to my dignity? When the God who made the heavens came down and held nothing back for me. I will lift up my hands, I will bow on my face, I will dance with my feet, I will jump up and praise. I will shout it out loud, He's released me from shame. All the nations shall worship, I'll do the same. I will lift up my hands, I will bow on my face, I will dance with my feet, I will jump up and praise. I will shout it out loud, He's released me from shame. All the nations shall worship, I'll do the same.
Praise You, God. Praise You, God. Praise You, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, it's so wonderful when you're in the land of the living and you know consciously that you're praising the Lord, that He's the only one to be praised, to be lifted up, and to give thanks unto. Oh, my Father God, He is so wonderful. He is so, so precious. I know He's precious to you, but I have to just make an acclamation. How good my Father is, how good He is to all of us, and to give us such good things. Oh, bless His holy name. If you notice that throughout this whole heat wave, that when it was just, that's it, no more, oh, I couldn't take another day, the Lord sent the rain and cooled it down. Did you notice that? what a gracious, good God we serve, that he would watch over us and love us and keep us. Perhaps in some other nation, some other country, they are crying out for the heat. Ah, and I'm sure that our Father is giving them the heat that they need. But here it is. It was simply enough. Oh, enough, Lord. And then they sent the rain and cooled it out. That's exactly what he does in our lives. When we are having more than we think we can bear. Oh, it's enough, Lord. It's enough. And surely, just as he sends the rain to cool this heat, he's going to send that help that you need and I need to take away all the enemy's trials that he's placing upon us. So what we do in the meantime? Oh, yes. We praise his holy name. We give him thanks and we sing hallelujah.
Yes. If you love the Lord, shout hallelujah. Because hallelujah is the highest praise. And truly he's worthy to be praised. Yes.
Look in my eyes and you will see all the fire. The fire burning in me. Can't you see a difference? God's presence through me. I worship him every day. He's worthy. He is worthy to be praised. My God, God Almighty, we worship you. We praise you. We lift up your holy name. Make a joyful noise unto the King. Let the heavens rejoice. Let all the angels sing hallelujah in the sanctuary. Hallelujah to the King of Kings. Woy woy. Hallelujah to the Son of God. Lord, we praise you. We worship you. We praise you forevermore. If God's people don't praise him, the rocks will cry, all the birds will sing, the wind will blow out his name. The mountains and the trees will bow down at his knees. Can't you see? God is worthy, Alpha and Omega. We worship you, we praise you, we lift up your holy name. Make a joyful noise unto the King. Let the heavens rejoice, let all the angels sing hallelujah in the sanctuary. Hallelujah to the King of Kings. Why? Hallelujah to the Son of God. Lord, we praise you, we worship you, we praise you forevermore. Praise him, oh praise him, oh yes, exalt his name. He is worthy, he is worthy to be praised. God's presence is around, give him the glory. He is the great I am, so come on and praise him. Joyful noise unto the King. Let the heavens rejoice. Let all the angels sing hallelujah in the sanctuary. Hallelujah to the King of Kings. Woo woo. Hallelujah to the Son of God. Lord, we praise you. We worship you. We praise you forevermore. Make a joyful noise unto the King. Let all the angels sing in the sanctuary. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, yes. Hallelujah to the Son of God. We praise you. We worship you. We praise you. Oh, oh yes. Make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise. Let all angels sing in the praise you, we worship you, we praise you forevermore. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Oh, we praise him forevermore. And that was Cora Williamson. Wasn't that pretty? That is hallelujah, praise our God. And so we will, indeed, we will praise him all day long.
Like friends and family. So it's a day full of life. It's a day full of hope. It's a day full of joy. So I thank you, 'cause it's a beautiful day. This is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice. Such a beautiful day. Rejoice in the Lord and be glad. It's a beautiful day. For heart I'll say, in spite of all, I'm thankful that you give me one more day.
It was a day
that could have got me down.
It was a day
I could have chosen to frown.
It was a day
that I made up my mind to thank you, 'cause it's a beautiful day.
This is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice.
Such a beautiful day.
Rejoice in the Lord.
It's a beautiful day.
This is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice.
Oh, such a beautiful day.
Rejoice in the Lord and be glad.
It's a beautiful day.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
The Lord has made.
Beautiful, beautiful,
in spite of what you're going through, come on, let's rejoice and be glad in it.
Beautiful,
if you're alive, you know you have another chance to make it a beautiful day.
For this is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice.
Such a beautiful.
You can bet it's a beautiful day. It is a beautiful day. And a praiseworthy welcome to 92.9 FM Choice Radio, to the ministry that went before me, the Word Ministry. The Lord bless you, and may you continue to give God the glory, the praise, lifting up his name and making sure that you have a message for the people, because they're listening, waiting, and wanting God's word. I thank God for you, and I pray that all will be well with you as you continue right here on Choice Radio. You know, we have been such a privilege for us, such a privilege, hallelujah. It is a privilege, a pleasure, and of course, it is our duty. And we thank God for this radio station, because it's God who's keeping it and God who is keeping us in it. I thank God particularly for a listener. I am just so excited. I was waiting to say this, but I simply have to say it now. The young lady who came in to get that cake yesterday on our own 007's program, Amanda, I think her name is, or Wanda, 14 years old, 13, 14. And what thrilled me so much, I tell you, I could just keep myself from calling in and just carrying on, but that she got saved on this radio station. Do you know what that means? Do you know? Well, double O, I tell you, I was so excited. I said, I'm going to hold it and talk about it on my program, because that was such a beautiful, marvelous testimony to Choice Radio. God is so mercifully wonderful that he rewards us. That's a reward to let us know that what we are doing is not in vain. And there is someone out there who wants to hear his word, who's waiting, whose heart is being opened unto the gospel. And I thank my Father for allowing her to be listening to Choice Radio 92.9 FM and hearing the word, because it's by hearing that faith comes. And she heard the word, the gospel being preached, because that is the way of salvation, and she accepted Jesus Christ in her heart. And I thank the Holy Ghost for drawing her right here in 92.9 FM Choice Radio. May the Lord continue to bless you. May he continue to hold up your love for him, and he will. Know that you are covered under the blood of Jesus, and nothing and no one can move you from that position. For the Lord Jesus says that the gates of hell shall not prevail against him. And that it means he is in you, and nothing is going to move him from you. Oh, what a blessing that is. And I tell you, just keep moving forward. Just keep moving forward, Amanda. I think that's your name. I was so excited when I heard that. I think I forgot the name fully. But I think it's Wanda or Amanda Harris. I'm not quite sure, but you know who you are. And for all of you out there who hear the word and accept Jesus Christ into your heart, and especially in your youth, I tell you, the blessings that are going to be following you and are upon you will remain forever unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. May he continue to bless you. I just wanted to let you know how excited I am and how happy I am that you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior. And you did it right here because of Choice Radio. So we've got a mission, and we are moving forward in it. So here's Houghton. We are moving forward.
Such freedom I have found in you. You're the healer who makes all things new. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm not going back, I'm moving ahead, here to declare to you my past is over. You, things are made new. Surrendered my life to Christ. I'm moving, moving forward. Oh, oh, oh. You've risen with all power in your hands. You have given me a second chance. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah, 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 oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Have become new. Oh, dear Paul, he wrote in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17 that behold, he says, therefore, hallelujah, therefore means therefore, for there is, this is what it says, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become quite new. Quite new. Oh, I'm going to read it just as it says here in this version of NIV. It says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone. The new has come. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. God has reconciled us to himself. God has made us one with him. God has taken away the old. We are not rehabilitated. We are not re-educated. We have not been renewed or reformed. We are recreated. We are brand new. Know that when you've asked Jesus Christ into your heart, that and you believe in your heart, not just saying the words, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Believe that he will. Believe that he is in you. And once you have done that, you are made brand new. The Holy Spirit in you has come to make you a whole new creation, a whole new person, the person that God intended you to be from the very beginning. And so, For all who have accepted Jesus, this is a new life. And you will feel new life. You will have new life. It will be such an experience of joy and love and praise. Oh, it's just so marvelous. So for all who have accepted Jesus Christ and who have come to the realization that he is, oh, what a blessing it is, that he is, know that you are brand new. You are brand new. And as a new babe in Christ, we lift you up tenderly. We hold you closely. We love on you. We joy as the angels rejoice in heaven over you. Oh, what a blessing it is. Christendom should be joying every minute, because every second the Holy Spirit is bringing in some new creation into the kingdom. So we should not be all evil and angry and bitter and weak-hearted. No, we should be rejoicing. And so I rejoice in the Lord for all whom the Lord is bringing, even right now as I speak. Perhaps not through me, but through someone else, somewhere in this great big wide cosmos. Someone is coming unto the Lord. Oh, what a blessing that is. Listen, it's enough to be glorious. It's enough to throw your hands up and praise him. Oh, isn't that what you want to do? I know that's what I'm doing.
Hallelujah. Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. But we can't forget where we come from. So if you don't mind, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
Thank you, Jesus. Listen.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, yes, it is the sweetest name.
Sweetest, sweetest name I know.
Come on and lift your hands and say it with me.
It is the sweetest name.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know.
Listen to this right here.
Some people say I'm crazy, but I can't explain.
No, no.
The power that I feel, oh, when I call your name.
When I call your name.
Said it's just like fire. Oh, oh, shut up in my bones.
Oh, oh,
yeah, the Holy Ghost is moving, y'all.
Yes, it is.
And it just won't leave me alone. Oh, there's something. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Something about the name.
Yes, it is.
Something about the name.
It is a
sweet name.
Oh,
I know.
I gotta be honest with you. I love.
Oh, how I love the name.
I love. I love the name.
Oh, how I love the name.
Yeah, it's the sweetest name.
Yes, it is.
Oh, yeah.
The sweetest name.
Yes, it is.
I know.
Listen. Said it's sweet. You can go on, shout, praise him, do it now. Oh, 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 yeah, 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 yeah.
Something about the name Jesus.
Oh, oh, oh.
Something about the name Jesus. It is the sweetest
name. Yeah,
yeah. I know.
I love the name.
I love the name.
Oh, I love the name.
I love the name.
know his name is sweet. Sweetest name I know.
Sweetest name I know.
Best thing that's ever happened to me,
yes,
y'all.
Yes.
Jesus. I love the name Jesus. Don't you? Say Jesus. Say it three times and then say it over and over and over again. Jesus. Oh, my Jesus. My sweet and precious Jesus. Oh, that name, that name, that name. Hallelujah, that name. Oh, praise the Lord God for that name. The name Jesus. Jesus, my Redeemer. Jesus, my Savior. What a name, a name which is above all names.
Oh God, you're high above all the nations, dominion beyond the sky. Yours is the name, filled with power and majesty. Sing.
Jesus, my Jesus, the name which is above every name, the name that gives you the victory, the name that lets you know that you can go through. And knowing that name, you want to spread that wondrous gospel all over the world. As Paul continues in the same chapter of 2 Corinthians, verse 5 and 11, and he talks so much about the ministry of reconciliation. He says, since then we know what it is to fear the Lord, we try to persuade men. In other words, we know it's in our bones, it's shut up in our bones, and we've eaten that word. And so we know, and we want to let you know, we want to let you know, if only you would just take it, take it, take it, take it. Oh, if you haven't taken the word and eaten it, oh, you are going to be so dissatisfied until you do. Take that word and eat it, that name which is above every name. He says, what we are is plain to God, and I hope it is also plain to your conscience. We are not trying to commend ourselves to you again, but are giving you an opportunity to take pride in us, so that you can answer those who take pride in what is seen rather than in what is in the heart. If we are out of our mind, it is for the sake of God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For Christ's love compels us, because we are convinced that one died for all, and therefore all died. And he died for all, that those who live should no longer live for themselves, but for him who died for them and was raised again. So from now on, we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, we do so no longer. And that's when he says, therefore, having said all of that, and having received and know who God is, he says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone. The new has come. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ. Oh, not counting men's sin against them. Isn't that exciting? Your sin is not counted against you. It is not imputed to you anymore. It has been taken away. All of your sins, all of your sins, the sins that you have done, the sin that you may be in, and the sin that you may do in the future, it's all covered in the blood. There is no condemnation. Of course you will not sin. Of course it is not your desire to sin. But the word of God says, if you do, if you should fall or stumble, if you should bump into that horrible pit again, you know that you've got Jesus, that you're covered, that his blood will cover you, that you come to him, repent, and ask forgiveness, and you move right on forward, just move forward in him. What a freedom, what a joy, what a privilege. Oh, let no man cast you down. Let no one point their finger in your face. You belong to Jesus, and it is a new day for you. And it's a happy day. Oh, what a happy day this is. Isn't it a happy day? Let's sing on to it.
When Jesus was when Jesus wore,
washed
my sins away. Happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, a happy day.
Oh, happy day.
When Jesus wore.
When Jesus wore.
Oh, when he wore.
When Jesus wore.
When Jesus wore.
When Jesus wore.
Washed my sins away.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, it's a happy day.
Oh,
happy day indeed. It's a happy day. You know, this today's program is inspired by that young lady who called in about her salvation. And I am not, she didn't call in, she was on in the studio. And I am just so grateful to her. And it shows how when you have become a new creature in Christ, that you are able to inspire and to encourage and to lift up the spirits of God's people and all people. I thank her so much. I dedicate this half, this first session of my program to her. And I tell you, I just want to big her up because of what she has done and the power that God has already placed in her life, that she can speak the word simply as it may sound and touch the hearts of so many. That's what God does for us when he makes us brand new. And I just love it. I trust you're having a happy day. A happy day, because you have made me, Miss S, very happy, and I thank God for you. I thank you for your boldness and the braveness in saying, I have received Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. There is nothing more exciting. You know, I tussled with coming out because the enemy has been trying to attack me. He sends his darts and apparently one has struck, but not for long. God is able to take care of us. And so I know I had to get off the bed of languishing and come on out here and lift up my God and give the devil a black eye. And so I thank you. I just want to thank you. Yes, I thank you. When something good has happened to you, when the brethren has been revived and given new strength and life, we ought to rejoice and we ought to give thanks and publish it so that others be encouraged. I am so encouraged by this young lady, and I thank God for you, I'm so sorry I didn't get your name correctly. But listen, know that God loves you. God loves you. You see how he's bigging you up? He loves you very much, our glorious, worshipful God.
Stars, and you call them by name, the sky.
God, you reign, you reign. You reign in the children, you reign in the adults, you reign in your people. God, you reign and you reign forever. Oh, on the outside, on the inside, on the above ground, on the beneath the ground, he reigns. Oh, I tell you, my God reigns. And thank you, my dear 007. God bless you, bless you. I cannot, oh, bless you enough. I cannot thank God enough for your love and your faithfulness and the way that he has recreated you. God is a marvelously wonderful God. I tell you, thank God, thank God. And for the name of my sister, whom I'm bigging up, Ewand, her name is Jamilia Hector. Jamilia, Jamilia, this is all for you today. You see what joyousness it is when you just big up the Lord and you call upon his name. He says, ooh, I'm going to big her up, and he is bigging you up. I tell you, I thank God for you. I continue to pray for you that he will do all the great things that he has in store for you. Take it one moment at a time and give him praise and give him joy and let your heart swell out unto him. And may your family, your grandma and your mother, father, brothers, sisters, cousins, may they all see this joyous light of God within you. Father God, I ask that you let her shine so brightly that she may continue to call on your name, to just lift you up and magnify you and to tell all the world about you. Father God, I don't know what it is you have in store for her, but whatever it is, you will do it. For you who hath begun a good work in her shall continue unto your coming. And so, Lord God, let your angels encamp about her. Continue to protect her. Open up her heart unto you the more that she may go forth and say, thus saith the Lord, whom I serve. Lord, bless Jamilia today. And wherever she goes today, may she beam with your joy. May she just light up the room. And wherever she may go, with your presence. Father, I thank you for her in Jesus' precious name. Oh, we just praise God for you, Jamilia.
For some who don't understand our purpose and may not understand our praise, we as a family in Jesus' name would like to tell you the reason why we sing. Family.
Someone asked a question, why do we sing? When we lift our hands to Jesus, what do we really mean? Someone may be wondering, when we sing a song, at times we may be crying, and nothing's even wrong.
I sing because I'm happy.
I sing because I'm happy.
I sing.
I sing because I'm happy.
His eyes on
the stem.
That's the reason.
That's the reason why I sing.
I want to know if you can help me say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason.
You're the reason why I sing.
Come on, say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. You're the reason.
The reason why I sing.
Can we say it again? Someone asked. Why do we sing?
Why do we sing?
When we lift our hands.
When we lift our hands to Jesus.
Oh, what do we really mean?
What do we really mean?
Someone may be wondering.
Someone may be wondering.
When we sing our song.
When we sing our song.
At times we may.
At times we may be crying.
And nothing's even wrong.
And nothing's even wrong.
This is the reason why I sing because
I sing because I'm happy.
I sing because
I sing because
oh, I don't know why he does it, but his eyes on
the spell.
the reason why.
You're the reason why.
Oh, hallelujah. I know I can get a witness in here. Glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason, Jesus.
You're the reason why.
I know I'm right about it. I just want to say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
I give the praises to you.
I give the praises to you.
Oh, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
You're the reason why.
You're the reason why. I
listen.
Sing.
And when the song is over. We've all said amen.
We've all said amen.
And your heart just keep on singing.
And your heart just keep on singing.
And the song will never
and
end.
And the song will never
listen.
End.
And if somebody asked you.
And if somebody asked you.
Was it just a show?
Was it just a show?
Lift your hands and be a witness.
Lift your hands and be a witness.
And tell the whole world no.
And tell the whole
listen.
World
no. When we cross that river,
and when we cross that river,
to study war no more,
to study war no more,
we will sing.
We will sing our song to Jesus,
the one whom we adore.
The one whom we adore.
Come on, family, let's take it home. I sing because
I sing because
I sing because.
I sing because
I don't know why he does it, but his eye. Jesus, I want to say glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
Oh, you're the reason, Lord. You're the reason.
You're the reason why I sing.
Can I say it again? Glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
I give the praises to you.
I give the praises.
Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you. You're the reason why I sing.
You're the reason why I sing.
You're the reason why I sing. You're my melody at midnight, Jesus. You're my song in my storm, Jesus. You're the hymn in my heart, Jesus.
You're the reason why.
You're the reason
why.
Oh, I love you. I love your name, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. For the rest of my life, Jesus, you'll be the reason why I sing.
Oh, let that be the reason why you sing. Let that be the reason why you are happy. Let that be the reason why you hope. The reason is Christ Jesus. Have you called? Have you asked him? Have you laid it all down at his feet? Have you said, Jesus, take me. I want to be yours. That's the reason why we sing, because we are one with him. He is all ours. He is all yours and mine and all the world. He is. That's the reason why we sing. That's the reason why he's God, for he can do all things, and all things are done just for him, just for him.
Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise God from whom all.
exalted thus. Worthy the Lamb our hearts replied, for He was slain for us. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. And praise Him above, you heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Son, give glory to the Spirit while endless ages run. Worthy the Lamb, all heaven cries, to be exalted thus. Worthy the Lamb, our hearts reply, for He was slain for us. Blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, you heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, you heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise Father, Son.
Oh, praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Oh, praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Holy, Holy Ghost. Oh, praise God. In Psalm 144, we praise God here again. Oh, all praises be to our God. Praise be to the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for war, my fingers for battle. He is my loving God and my fortress, my stronghold and my deliverer, my shield in whom I take refuge, who subdues peoples under me. O Lord, what is man that you care for him? The son of man that you think of him? Man is like a breath. His days are like a fleeting shadow. Part your heavens, O Lord, and come down. Touch the mountains so that they smoke. Send forth lightning and scatter the enemies. Shoot your arrows and rout them. Reach down your hand from on high. Deliver me and rescue me from the mighty waters, from the hands of foreigners whose troubles or whose mouths are full of lies, whose right hands are deceitful. Oh, I will sing a new song to God. I will sing a new song to you, O God, on the 10-stringed lyre. I will make music for you and to you, to the one who gives victory to kings, who delivers his servant David from the deadly sword. Deliver me and rescue me from the hands of foreigners whose mouths are full of lies, whose right hands are deceitful. Then our sons in their youth will be like well-nurtured plants, and our daughters will be like pillars carved to adorn a palace. Our barns will be filled with every kind of provision. Our sheep will increase by thousands, by tens of thousands in our fields. Our oxen will draw heavy loads. There will be no breaching of walls, no going into captivity, no cry of distress in our streets. Blessed are the people of whom this is true. Blessed are the people whose God is the Lord. Oh, our blessings go out to our God this day, to our people, to our neighbors, to our community, to all that is near and dear to us, and to our city, O God, and to this land, Father, and to your people, to your people who are so oppressed, to your people whom the enemy have no fear to cast down. And Lord, I am crying out to you right now because of what has been going on, the injustice in our land. Yes, many may say that it is right or it is good, but Lord, let them open their eyes that they may see through the justice of God, through the way God wants things done, that we may call upon you and that our children may rise up and be glorified in you. And even in this country, in this city, in this world over, Father, we give you the glory, we give you the praise, for it's only in you, it's only in you that we conquer and have the victory. And so, Lord God, we thank you that even as we go forth, and even as we cry in the streets, and even as we plead and speak out against injustice, that we will remember that you are our God, and that you see everything that occurs, and that you are in everything that occurs. And Lord, we ask that you will look down and touch hearts and minds, and especially families that are struggling with dealing with the truth and injustice. Father, have your way in all of our lives, even the good and the bad, and redeem us for your holy name's sake, I pray, in Jesus' name. And I'm reaching out for the families and all who are affected, including myself, in the situation with the Trayvon Martin protests. But I do know that it's only in Christ, can we get justice and can we be at peace one with the other. And I pray that that's what we will seek today as we sit in our congregations, as we go to church, and as we call upon God to be merciful unto us, that we will bow and be humbled and let him come down and touch our land, touch our hearts, touch our lives, touch our beings. Oh, if we can just humble ourselves, if we can just come together and pray and ask God to have mercy. Have mercy, O Lord, have mercy upon us, I pray. Father, I thank you in Jesus' holy name that you are God and I can come to you boldly and call upon you to intervene in the lives and in the ways of our land and our people. And you will, for I ask it in Jesus' precious holy name. As you go forth and as we continue to live and breathe and move and have our being in Christ, that we must remember that it's only in Christ, it's only in the Lord. No matter what the trial, no matter what the tribulation, no matter how men may expound and carry on, we must know that underneath is his everlasting arms, and he's the one who will take us through always, always, if we would just humble ourselves and call on him. But God in his mercy is answering many prayers. God in his love for this nation is pulling out the evil that has been thrown upon it. And you see, it's surfacing. And as we continue to love one another, it's only in love, in peace, and in faithfulness can we have righteousness. Let God be among us. Let God be with us and live out his creed in us. Oh, if we could just expound and expand ourselves onto his grace and let it just saturate us, saturate our thoughts, our thinking. Oh, that our children, oh God, our children will see and understand and walk rightly with God. Let us boldly look to the Lord our God as we praise him and as we lift up our voices and ask him to bless us.
Give thanks to the Lord. are the King. His love endures forever. He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. His mighty hand and His outstretched arm, His love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, His love endures forever. Sing praise. Setting sun, His love endures forever. By the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful. God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. Forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever. His love endures forever.
And forever He is strong. Forever. He's not just for a moment or a blink or a wink. He is forever. He has always been and always will be. He is God all by himself. And so we give him glory, we give him praise, and we thank him. For he's God all by himself, I tell you. Oh, someone is calling me. Obviously, they're not listening to me, but I'll talk to you later. Ah, the Lord is good, isn't he? Yes, he is. He is precious in all his ways. And so we love him, and we lift up his holy name. And I'm going to start a little early today with my children. I just want to get into the book of Micah. That's where we are. We just left Jonah, which was so good. We can talk of Jonah all day long because so many of us get the call and just don't answer. Or even if we answer in the opposite direction. And that was what Jonah was all about. And so here we are with Micah. We are now in the book of Micah. Boys and girls, are you there? Yes, okay. I hope you've got your Bibles. I hope you are opening it up. Call mom or dad if you can't have a Bible, if you don't have a Bible. Listen, if you don't have a Bible and you can't get one, just let me know. Give us a call and I will be happy to provide you with a Bible. If nothing else, I know that I have a Bible that I can give to you. So if you don't have a Bible, please call me on 917-723-3105 or call us right here at Choice Radio and I will be sure to get you a Bible. All right? I will be sure to get you a Bible. Call me right here at 347-663-8638, right here, Choice Radio. Wow, will I not give you a Bible? Oh dear, if I know you need a Bible, I will be more than happy to get one for you. So, if I have a taker, make sure you call, and believe me, I will get it to you. All right, having a Bible is very important, especially if you've just accepted Christ as your Savior. You want to know all about him. He's your new love, your only love, your eternal love. You want to know all about him. And you will only know all about him through his word. Through the word of God, which is the Bible. From Genesis to Revelation. I just heard one person says, from Genesis to the maps. For the end of the book, they have all these maps at the end of the book. But no, from Genesis to Revelation. The maps just tell you all about the places where the word was brought. All right, so we read his word to learn of him. And right here in Micah, M-I-C-A-H is the name of the prophet whose work we are going to study right now. And Micah was one of those prophets who, again, was called by God to present his truth and his word to the children of Israel. Micah came in at a time when Isaiah was around. He was one of Isaiah's friends, or if not friends, they knew each other. Hosea was one of the people around that time when Micah came through. So Micah didn't just come out of some kind of obscurity and no one knew of him. He was well known. He was during the time of the kings, King Hezekiah, King Jotham, and King Ahaz. These are those times. So it wasn't just a book that just happened. It was there's a whole history behind this man. He loved God, and God called him to give his word to the people. Why? Generally, when God has to call a prophet out and speak to his people, is to let his people know that the things that they're doing are not pleasing to him. See, when you please God with holy living, when you please God with right living, when you please God with offering yourself unto him, you and him and all around you are blessed, are happy and fruitful. When you don't, when you do those things that are displeasing to him, like lying and cheating and speaking ill of each other and fighting against each other and being unjust, those things are not pleasing to God. God wants us to do what's right. Even Micah said that in his word. In one of the key verses in the book of Micah, it says that the question is asked, what would the Lord want you to do? And he says, he has showed you, O man, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you is to act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God. So there are things that you have to do and do it right in God's sight in order for him to prosper in you, to flourish in you. When the enemy comes against you, to repel the enemy, to let the enemy go. And the enemy comes in all different forms and shapes. And so we just have to rely on God to just be there for us and stand with us to go forward. I don't care who you are, what you've done and how holy you are, the enemy will target you. Don't matter how long and how strong, he will target you. He will come after you as he did with Job. And he will say, look at your daughter there. Look at your son. Oh, they're only loving you because you love them and protect them. And then God will say, oh, really? Well, let's find out if that's true. But God knows your heart. He knows you love him. And he knows that you get weak in the flesh, but he will send help and he will rescue you. And so here is Micah telling the people of Israel in the northern end and in the southern end to stop. Stop their wicked ways, because God is not pleased. God was not pleased. And so Micah came forth to tell of the judgment that will come upon the people. But in all of the judgment, in all of the punishment, God says to them, but if you repent and if you turn from your wicked ways, God will pardon you. You will be pardoned. Isn't that exciting? And the same thing happens today. When we turn from our wicked ways, the Lord pardons us. When we say we are sorry, when we are truly sorry and ask God to forgive us, show us the right way and help us to walk in that way, God does. And that evil that may come against you tends to go away. And not tends to, but go, because they have to. And so we must learn to listen. Listen. We must hear and listen. There's a difference. You can hear, but are you listening? You can hear, but are you listening? So we ask God to let us hear to listen. All right? And we listen to the promises that God has in his word for us when we turn from our wicked, wicked ways. And so we have another prophet who's here talking to the people, not just to the people of Israel, but to the people of today. He, God, wants all of us to turn away and look to him. He is indeed and a God of love. He is indeed a God who loves us. If he didn't love us, he would not send his only begotten Son into the world to save us. So God indeed is a God of love. He's also a God who is a God who hates. He hates. What do I mean? What do you mean he hates? How can he love and hate? Yes, he hates sin. He hates sin. And God will punish sin. He doesn't hate you, but he hates the actions that you do that are sinful, that are displeasing to him. And if we turn, he will turn also. He will continue to do what's right and good for us. All right? And that's for everyone, whether you are a babe in Christ, whether you are an old person, whether you are on your deathbed, whether you are flying high and saying, oh, nothing can happen to me. Look where I am. I've got this great job. I've got so much money. I've got all these good clothes. I can party. I can go where I want and do what I want. I can call up the airlines and I can fly. Oh, no matter what, God is still for you, for all of us. He is a God of mercy and he loves us. Oh, but he does not like when we mix our motives with empty display of religion or perversion. He doesn't like that at all. And so what we need to do is come unto him, repent, turn away from all of our evil ways, thoughts, and actions, and he will sup with us. He will walk with us. He will talk with us. And we will be so happy. We will be at peace. And we will have joy unspeakable. And so, as I continue with Micah, let's just read the very first chapter. And then I have one verse that I want you to remember and study and learn. So, we begin in this particular version or interpretation of the word with NIV. It says, the word of the Lord that came to Micah of Moresheth during the reigns of Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, kings of Judah, the vision he saw concerning Samaria and Jerusalem. Now here is Micah. He's from Moresheth, and he is getting this vision. This word of the Lord is coming strongly in his heart and in his life about the two kingdoms, the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, Samaria and Jerusalem, unto the people. And it goes on to say, hear, O people, all of you, listen, listen, O earth. That means every one of us. Listen, O earth, and all who are in it, that the sovereign Lord may witness against you, the Lord from his holy temple. Look, the Lord is coming. He's coming from his dwelling place. He comes down and treads the high places of the earth. The mountains melt beneath him, and the valleys split apart like wax before the fire, like water rushing down a slope. All this is because of Jacob's transgression. Transgression means sin. Because of the sins of the house of Israel. What is Jacob's transgression? Is it not Samaria? What is Judah's high place? Is it not Jerusalem? See, they were only thinking of these places and doing all the things in them that they shouldn't. And so God is pointing out their sin. He says, therefore, I will make Samaria a heap of rubble, a place for planting vineyards. I will pour her stones into the valley and lay bare her foundations. All her idols will be broken to pieces. All her temple gifts will be burned with fire. I will destroy all her images. Since she gathered her gifts from the wages of prostitutes, as the wages of prostitutes, they will again be used. Now, God in this section is talking about the desolation and the destruction that is coming upon that land, all the land. And now, as if we were to put in just a position what's going on in these country, in our country, we see all these fires that are just rising up and unbearably cannot be put out. Even the men who are putting the fires out are being burnt up. We just had that tragedy with the firemen who were burnt, all 19 of them. And you notice just one escaped. The Bible talks about things happening and just one escape to tell about it. When we hear these things and we see them, look into the Word of God to understand what He is saying unto us, even today, right now. Things that are going on in our land, the drought, the temperature, the hurricanes, all of these awful things that are coming upon us and upon our people. Even our homes are being burnt. Oh, the carelessness of life. Our hospitals are being closed. And all of these things are going on around us that affect each and every one of us. And so we ask, how long is this going to go on? What is it that we must do? Well, he continues in that chapter. He says, because of this, I will weep and wail. Now, you be asked, what should we do? And he says, because of this, I will weep and wail. I will go about barefoot and naked. I will howl like a jackal and moan like an owl, for her wound is incurable. It has come to Judah. It has reached the very gate of my people, even to Jerusalem itself. Tell it not in Gath. Weep not at all in Beth Ophrah. Roll in the dust. Pass on in nakedness and shame, you who live in Shaphir. Those who live in Zaanan will not come out. Beth Ezel is in mourning. Its protection is taken from you. Those who live in Maroth writhe in pain, waiting for relief, because disaster has come from the Lord, even to the gate of Jerusalem. You who live in Lachish, harnessed the team to the chariot. You were the beginning of sin to the daughter of Zion, for the transgressions of Israel were found in you. Therefore you will give parting gifts to Mosheth Gath. The town of Akzib will prove deceptive to the kings of Israel. It will bring a conqueror against you who live in Marisha. He who is the glory of Israel will come to Adullam. And he's saying, with all of this that's happening, what are you doing? What are we doing? Are we calling on God to have mercy? Are we repenting? Are we lifting up our hearts? He says in verse 16, shave your heads in mourning for the children in whom you delight. Make yourselves as bald as the vulture, for they will go from you into exile. Oh, what a piteous time. What a tragic time. Oh, and we can even see it in our time. Don't close your eyes to it. This whole Trayvon Martin travesty of our children being gunned down, of our people being heartless, of our justice system not working, not just for black people, but for all people. I mean, the transgression is within the land. It is in the people. Remember that it's not just black people that have called upon the name of the Lord and are saved. It's all people. God has pulled his people out of all nations, all races, and all tongues. So when we look at the tragedy and we look at the failings of what's going on, we must think not of ourselves, but of everyone, of all that are involved, and each and every one, your neighbors, your friends, your cousins, your family, everyone is involved, and everyone is touched by the transgression, by the sin, by the violence, by the heartlessness of all that goes around. And yes, our children become captive of the enemy. They go into exile. They're not even able to read or write. They're not able to think correctly. Or they're just so drawn into such evil, into pornography, into prostitution, into the devil's mire, into the devil's lair, or into the prisons, sometimes for absolutely nothing. Oh, what a terrible, terrible tragedy that we are looking at, and it is written in God's word. Here it is in Micah. Micah is talking about the things that are going on in Israel. And it is exactly what's happening right here, right now, as we look upon the land where we live, and as we look upon ourselves, and even deep into our hearts. We fear so strongly. And instead of sitting back and stop and say, "Behold, I am unworthy, Lord. I must humble myself." The hardness of our hearts, even to humble ourselves. We are so afraid, serious fear, to just stop and say, "Lord, I'm going to fast on this today. I'm going to call upon your name about this today." The fear of the Lord has gone so far from us that we are not even able to bring it back into the midst and say, "Lord God, help. Please help. I've listened and watched the protests and so forth, and I'm yet to hear the prayer, the cry out unto the God of all flesh to have mercy upon us." And that's what we need to do. Yes, we can march. Yes, we can shout. Yes, we can carry our banners. But please let us have a banner that says, "God, have mercy. God, please come into the midst of us and help us. Let us turn from our wicked, wicked ways and humble ourselves and call upon your name so that our land will be saved and our people all will not go in such shame and degradation and nakedness, and our children will not fall by the sword of the enemy. Help us, O God." We need to call. We need to cry out in our churches, in the pulpits, in our seats, in our homes, everywhere we go. This is not hard, but this is the time when this must happen. We must cry out to the God of all flesh, to the God who loves us, who sent his Son, who died for us. Oh, we're crying out. Those of us who are the Micahs of the land, cry out loudly, painfully. This is not time for mirth and entertainment. This is time for sackcloth and ashes, of mourning and being sorry, for the foulness that we found ourselves in. We must call our children together, put our arms around them and nestle with them and let them see and know that God is in the midst and he is the only deliverer. He is the only one that can bring us out of this miry clay that we have found ourselves in. And so Micah continues, and he just goes on and on. And here in chapter 6, verse 8, is the word that I want you to recall and remember and to put into your memory. It says, and beginning at the 6th verse, it says, "With what shall I come before the Lord and bow down before the exalted God? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with 10,000 rivers of oil? Shall I offer my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul?" He has, and Micah says it, and this you must learn. "He has showed you, O man, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? He requires that you act justly, and that you love mercy, and that you walk humbly with him." That's what God requires from all of us, and especially from us, his children. If you call yourself a child of God, this is what you must do. You must walk and act justly. You must love mercy. You must walk humbly before your God. It is not in the things that you acquire. It is not in the material things and the blessings that God has given to you. It is what's in your heart towards him. How do you act with your neighbor, with your friends, with your family even? How do we act? Are we merciful? Are we kind? God is the God indeed of love. Are we loving as God loves? Oh, this is time to turn and time to reach out and cry out. Yes, not to be ashamed to do that, but to be ashamed not to do that. God is in the midst of us, and we will not be moved because he will help us, and that right early. So give God the glory. Give him the praise. Children, continue to love and call on God and lift up your heart unto him and let his light shine within you that you may do good, and he will see and others will see the God in you. All right? Continue to read Micah as we sing. Shine for Jesus Christ. And you will too. You are going to let your light shine. Shine for the Lord. And continue to live for him. For he is God and he is the only one that you need to reach out to. All right? So let the Lord continue to bless you. Have a blessed week. And continue to serve the Lord. Remember us here at 92.9 FM Choice Radio to be a blessing unto this station. Be a blessing that we may continue to let the word of God go forth and that he may continue to bless us. If you bless God's people, you too will be blessed. All right? Here you go. Don't let Satan blow it out. Please, let your word shine. And thank you for all who called today. My dear sister Hyacinth, may you have a blessed day in church today. And may you too be blessed, my dear sister Antonio. And thank you for the word that you sent from 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. verse 8, 9. That was such a blessing. And I thank God for you. Continue to love God and send His word out there and give God the glory. Keep it locked right here, for you will hear our own Pastor Ferdinand's message and his teaching. Please hold on to it, because you will have to give account for this good teaching that you get from our own Pastor Ferdinand. All right? God bless you. Have a good week. And keep it locked again. Keep it locked right here. I love you. God bless you. Continue to love our God. Amen.
We're going to teach you this song. Come on, sing, sing it. Sing it again now. I said, oh, 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 it all comes down to love. Oh, 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 Michael, you can come join me on stage too. Listen. Said talking heads talking to us on the television. Silver screen preachers, politicians say they got the answers. First they want to squeeze us. Send a little money, what a tax on Jesus. Fix it with a prayer, fix it with a dollar. Anybody out there ever wanna holler for? Oh, 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 it all comes down to love. Oh, 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 that's all I wanna say is, oh, 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 I can't hear you. It all comes down to love. Oh, 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 oh. Oh,
Good God, man! The Bible said in the last days, I shall pour out my spirit upon...
Will you be seated? And let's turn.